about 5 hours later. It is raining out now. Pellets are still good, I guess. But, I think we are in another fire out situation. I don't know how. My meat's already at 170. Pellets dropping. I see no smoke. I'm going to put some gloves on again. This is getting really old. Fire is definitely out again. I'm going to try to work it on. pretty sure that it was out again. Yeah, it's probably been about four and a half hours. It went out again. Hopper was fully loaded before I went to sleep. I forgot to turn off my work alarm. So luckily that woke me up. And I looked at the temperature. It said like 120 degrees again. Are relighting the damn thing again. I don't know how my meat got so far along. Maybe I'm just pulling out of the stall or still in the stall. But I don't like it. Into the colder spots. Carry on. I guess I'm gonna turn this back down to .205. On 215, but that one's probing 162. I might as well stick the other probe in. Oh, I don't like that. These are probing way too easy. This time, it's 167. Let me recheck a probe. Bottom one definitely not ready. Maybe I just need a really soft spot, but these things are probing super high for the amount of weight. The time I have into it right now. I'm at 180. Temp's coming back up. This is really old. Fire out again. I don't know. I mean, I could have put a pan in it, but why is a pan gonna stop it from firing out? I definitely wasn't lit, had to light it. Less than 5 hours later, hopper was full. There wasn't really a big void or anything that I've seen, but I don't know. This is getting really, really old. I'm gonna let it heat up. I hope this meat slows down because we are going way too fast. It's about 5 in the morning. And I need this to be done 7 hours from now. And I don't think that's going to work out math wise. But there's a lot of smoke. There's a lot of fire down there. Sit here and wash this for now. 205 temp reached. But I'm gonna guess that there's a grease fire because I didn't put a pan down there. Maybe that's why it shut down. Yep, I think that's why it shut down. I'm gonna get another pair of gloves. Pull this meat off. This is definitely what some people want to see. A fucking grease fire. I guess it was to be expected. I am going to let it burn out. I guess clean the pot out. TP this thing and clean the grill, I guess. you definitely do need a drip tray. I knew it was gonna be a good possibility. I was gonna get a fire, but had to see it for myself, I guess. I'm gonna go ahead and go into shutdown mode, because I've seen enough. Just put it in shutdown. Definitely some fire going. But I'm gonna keep the lid closed. Try to keep the fire to a minimum. Let me grab a charger. My phone's about to die. I'm ready to run. Definitely got a fire going in there. I hear the grease sizzling. Take a peek. See a lot of embers underneath popping out through the cracks. Definitely not opening the bottom door. But you can see some embers down there. Take a peek under this. I'm pretty sure there's gonna be a big fire. I can hear it. I can see all the smoke. Definitely a big old fire down there. Yeah. fanned, or this fan in shutdown mode. Stop the camera for a second to see what the app's saying. Well, I think the bottom's lit on fire. I'm about to just power this down so it stops blowing air. But the bottom tray definitely looks lit up down there. I'm not gonna open it because just feeding it more air. I'm gonna go ahead and turn this thing off all the way so it stops blowing air into a fire. This might be the end of me with this weather. I might return it today. This is fucking ridiculous. I'm gonna guess this thing's ripping above 600 right now. I went to shut down around, I don't know, it was still probably under 300 degrees. But it's ripping. It's definitely on fire. Popped it open for a second and it just went whoosh again. But the bottom tray looks like it's on fire. I don't want to open it again or open it at all, but it looks like it's on fire. There's fire still going in there. No, I guess it's a waiting game right now. Let this grease fire burn out. That bottom tray has definitely got a fire going in it. Yeah, I know this is a pretty extreme amount of meat on it, but it fit on it. I feel like my grill shouldn't have a warning about how much meat I'm supposed to throw on it at a time. sounds less crazy right now. Fire's still going. Let's reach the top grates. Definitely feel a lot safer without a freaking wind storm in there blowing stuff up, fanning the flames, I guess you would call it. But the bottom tray definitely on fire as well. I can see the light dancing around in there. We're gonna keep us rolling. The meat last probed at like 170s. One was still in 160s. But I think I'm out of stall already somehow. It's been maybe 12 hours. 210, or I'm guessing around 15 pound briskets trimmed out. Math doesn't make sense, but here we are. I'm hoping we just got out of the stall, but I don't know. I'm going to keep on waiting with you guys. Fire's still there. I guess I should have used drip trays, because it definitely can't handle it. The bottom tray looks like the fire's out down there. I don't see anything dancing around. I don't know. Maybe the tray wasn't on fire and I'm just seeing the fire from the top box lighting, emitting light down there. Leave this open, I guess. I'm gonna start cleaning it. I really don't have room on my kettle for 3 briskets, so I'm gonna clean this all the way and start it back up, which I don't really mind because my meat is going way too fast right now. Cool down ain't too bad. The stars aligned. Glad I forgot to turn off my work alarm. I wasn't planning on waking up for another 2 hours. Thank you. flashlight on my phone just turned off. But it did. Maybe I'm overheating. But I have no over temp alarm on my phone. But fire is almost out. Just got a little corner over here. Still going. But I'm gonna keep it rolling. It's a pretty long video right now. I don't know how I'm gonna be cutting this up. I'm leaving it whole. Continue cleaning this crap out. Stop talking because I'm just going to be cleaning. Everything is definitely ripping hot. These bars are pretty cleaned up from that fire. I guess that's a good part. I don't know what this cracking is in the back, if it's paint or what. But I don't think that's just the ash. I think that part was silver before. At this point, I think I'm gonna return it. I'm gonna hit Weber up, see what they say about this. I'm gonna assume they're gonna say you should have put a drip tray in it, but I didn't buy this thing to put drip trays in it every cook, because all my cooks are gonna be pretty substantial like this. I mean, if I'm gonna fire up the grill or fire up the smoker, I usually like to have it loaded. I just hit up all my buddies and tell them I'm gonna be smoking. Basically, have them buy me meat or I'll buy them meat and load it up. But I'm not trying to pay for drip trays. for the whole ownership of his grill. So, I don't know. I might get a smoker with a drip tray and return this thing. Just gotta see what Weber's gonna say about this. Cause that's hot. That's fucking ripping hot. Holy shit. I am wearing heat gloves, but not 600 degrees heat gloves. Oh no, let me reposition this out of the light. I guess I can unplug the grill now. Let me turn the grill on, see what it says happened. Fire's out. Definitely feels a lot calmer when there's not freaking air-fed grease fire going. It says nothing about me powering it down incorrectly. It just started up on this screen. Temp says 170 with the grill wide open for, I don't know, about 30 minutes now probably. Yeah, good fun times. Get a pellet grill, they said. Life will be easy. There's definitely pellets up by the chute up there. I don't know how they got up there, but they did. And, now we're here. I wish the light on my phone would turn back on, but I don't want to stop the recording, so we're going to continue on recording. My phone was charged, but it's not. I'm tethering off my big old speaker right now. Yeah, pellets are up there somehow, underneath the auger. On top of the auger. I should have looked at it more before I tried to start it back up. But hindsight is 2020. stupid spatula thing. But it's all ash in there. It's pretty thick right now. This mostly grease burnt out in the fire. Let's open up this box, see what it looks like. Pretty full. Not much ash down here. I don't know if you can see any of this, because this is definitely not much ash for the ash catcher. More ash in the tray or the cook box. But the grease drip tray is pretty full. I'm gonna say about halfway full. I'm gonna continue scraping this. I'm gonna reline that grease tray and start her back up. I'm gonna start recording because it's been 43 minutes already. I'll be back.